In American comic books, there are only two major publishers, DC and Marvel. DC founded in 1938 with Superman, essentially, and Marvel being founded in the early 1960s with The Amazing Spider-Man, The Fantastic Four, The X-Men, The Avengers, and The Incredible Hulk. Readers originally had no problem just with the two publishers, as these companies had lots of comic titles for readers to choose from. But something began to happen. By the 1980s, writers and artists were complaining that their rights were being diminished. Any character created by a writer or artist became property of the publisher, and not of the writer or artist themselves. Originally, when Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster created Superman, it was their character, but they were convinced, or rather forced, to sell the character's rights to DC. It then became company policy for creations to become the property of the publisher and not of the writer or artist. This remains in effect to this day in American comic publishing, but in the mid to late 1980s, a group of men decided to try and change this. I remember this making lots of news in the comic world at the time because no one thought that such a thing could still be done. Key freelance writers and artists working for Marvel at the time were fed up with the lack of rights that they had. Marvel ignored their request for fair compensation and creative freedom, so they decided to band together and form their own independent company, Image Comics. Some of these people were legends of the modern comic book industry, such as Jim Lee, Todd McFarlane, Mark Silvestri, Eric Larson, and a few others. When the news became public, this was considered a coup d'etat by the established comic book industry. Two key points of Image would be, firstly, the company would not hold rights to a character, the creating writer or artist would. And secondly, writers, artists would not interfere with each other's work, meaning everyone would stay to their own projects. No infighting. Well, at least not yet. Image proved to be so successful that clashes within the company naturally came about, and some even left Image to form their own companies or go with other ventures. Wildstorm and Top Cow being perfect examples of this. Dark Horse was actually around slightly longer than Image. Often importing Japanese manga comics, it can be said that the independent realm of American comics is the domain of Image, naturally being the largest, and sharing space with Dark Horse and smaller brands such as Dynamite, and even spin-offs of Image such as Wildstorm and Top Cow. But the reasons for independent comics thriving at the time were also worth considering, as I believe it will be one of the main focuses of this comic book narration. Readers in the late 1980s and early 1990s wanted something different. They were ready for something edgy and new. Young people at the time wanted to check something different than the established DC and Marvel. They wanted to be in on the new thing. Image was that new thing. Another reason why I think Image was so successful is because of their tactics that they used and how they were similar to when Marvel was formed. When Marvel was formed, it went against DC. Marvel immediately came out with very strong and popular titles, the strongest being Spider-Man. Image came out with Spawn, Witchblade, Savage Dragon, and later on, The Darkness and Fathom. The Image universe was built around these comic lines, and characters from these comics are the most important within the Image universe. In today's world, I doubt that this kind of success can be repeated, because like I mentioned in the previous narration, no one reads comics anymore. But at the same time, if it's done right, and done for the times that we live in, I think there may be a chance. What do you think?